YouTubers, and welcome to my latest movie review. Today, it's the review you've been waiting for, Frozen 2, the very long-awaited sequel to the surprisingly popular animated film from 2013, Frozen, which was actually rather more successful, I think, than anybody anticipated. And of course, great success means a sequel, so... Frozen 2, only just come out in the cinemas, so do go and see it if you get a chance. So, the basic plot of Frozen 2 is that Elsa starts hearing this voice calling to her from another sort of kingdom somewhere far off, and she wants to find out what it is and the source of its power, and it also leads her to go on a quest with her sister and Kristoff and the reindeer Sven to find out where this is coming from, and also Elsa wants to discover, also has to discover the origin of her power, as well as some other revelations about her and Anna's past. And that is essentially what you've got going on in Frozen 2. That's the basic setup anyway. Frozen 2. now, I have reviewed the first one, and please watch that review if you haven't seen it, but I basically said in my review of the first one that I liked the first one. I think it was solid. It was good fun for what it was. Completely overhyped and overrated. But, yeah. I still enjoyed it for what it was. This one... Well... unfortunately, I don't think Frozen 2 is as good as the first one. It doesn't really matter that I say that, because this film is not aimed for people like me. This film is aimed for younger kids, particularly young girls. The young girls who grew up with the first one and watching the first one will probably, most probably, enjoy Frozen 2. I think that it definitely looks better than the first one. The animation, the animation for the first one still looked great, but in 6 years, the technology has improved, and you can tell that they really have spent a lot of money on this animation, and it does look pretty good. Especially that scene when Elsa tries to scale over the tidal wave with her powers. That's really cool. It was the first sort of teaser trailer we saw of her trying to get over the big wave. That's in this movie, and that was very well done. this movie is not perfect. Far from it. But I think it's entertaining. It's fun. It'll keep young girls... entertained for a good hour and a half, you know. The characters are pretty good, regardless of how some people are used. I like Elsa very much. I think Elsa is definitely the sort of the main character of this film. She goes on a huge journey of self-discovery. And we do explore the origins of her powers, but quite what the revelation of that is, to be honest, kind of confusing. When I heard it, I won't go into spoilers, but when I heard about what it was, when I was watching the movie and I saw what it was, I was like, oh, okay, right. It didn't really make a lot of sense to me, so I may have to watch this movie again or look at spoiler talks of other people to fully understand it. But, I think she goes on a quite an emotional journey this time, and I like the dynamic between the sisters, Elsa and Anna. Their bond. I'm calling her Anna because I'm English. I'm from England. It's easier. So Elsa and Anna are good in this film. I like Anna's journey as a character. She's not as naive as she was in the first one, and she definitely takes charge a bit more. And she starts to kind of, she wants to be there for her sister. So that's quite nice. Kristoff, though, is completely wasted. I don't know why he's even in this movie. He's basically, his story arc is that he's trying to propose to Anna because he wants to marry her. And yet he's struggling to do so. Every time he tries to do it, she seems to mishear what he says. And then he can't. So there's this other guy that helps him out. And then And then they just leave him behind, like, what the hell? For no reason. And then it leads to this long sequence of him singing a song about how he thinks him and Anna are growing apart. And it just seemed a bit unnecessary, really. But yeah, the story of this movie, while it's quite a cool idea, it gets, like, in the second half, it gets kind of muddled. Like, it's definitely more complicated than the first one. I mean, there are parts that I kind of got, but there were other parts I was thinking, hang on a minute, there's a lot of exposition in this film, particularly when they have the revelations of the past, because there was this whole exposition in the first scene of this movie about how there was like the Kingdom of Arendor, and then there was these people of the forest that had this that had this kind of war and whatnot, and it was kind of a load of mumbo jumbo, really. My brain kind of lost some of the information towards the end. Anyway, I was like, "What the hell?" I'm kind of lost where we are here. So, story wise, like narratively, it's a neat premise, but not everything is quite fully explained. And also, there might be some continuity issues from the first movie to this movie. So. Yeah, I'm not going to pick them out individually because I don't know the movies as well as other people. But if you're a true fan of Frozen, you'll probably pick up on some of those inconsistencies, shall we say. But, you know, far be it from that. It is still an entertaining film. It's still fun. You know, not quite as good as the first one, but it's still fun. Olaf, though. Oh God. Olaf, they got him so right in the first movie. And, he was an accidental success. You know, no one knew he was going to be good. I actually kind of liked him in the first one. I thought he was quite fun, and they didn't overuse him. In this one, they overuse him. His song in this one is not as good as well. He's the comic relief, and that's all he was intended to be, but the comedy in this film is very hit and miss. Like, the humor's just, it doesn't really make a lot of sense. It's just a bit weird. I mean, again, I know the humor's more aimed for kids, and that's fine, but I don't know if kids will get all the jokes, to be quite honest. And at the end of the day, Olaf was just, you know, he was just annoying, really. That was all I can say. Sad, because I like him in the first movie. I think Sterling K. Brown voices Matthias, who's this general. He's good. He's very good. There are some other good voice actors in this movie. Kieran Hines actually returns as the little troll that was in the first one, which is good. Again, some other dumb decisions that this movie makes is in the beginning of the movie when Elsa decides to go on the quest to find out where this voice is. Her sister comes with her, and Kristoff also comes with them, and Sven comes with them, so leaving Arendelle completely rulerless. Although this time, obviously, Hans isn't there, so basically the trolls look after the people. Like, what? Like, because they have to evacuate Arendelle due to these natural disasters that are happening, all due to this thing that they have to stop. It just leaves me thinking, my God, are these people dumb or what? Like, you know, clearly, like they don't value the people very much if they just leave them in the hands of the trolls. I mean, what? It's just such a dumb decision. I mean, you might as well have left Kristoff there, because Kristoff was barely in the film anyway, so why not just leave him there? Like, and then Kristoff just turns up at the end as well. Like, he just somehow manages to find out where they are and catch up with them. Like, yeah, there's things in this movie that don't make sense. But yeah, it is a visual treat. There's some good sort of fun action sequences in this movie. Young girls are going to enjoy it, and I think they're going to enjoy the relationship with the sisters. And I think that is the thing that really sort of draws me to the movie is the relationship between the sisters. And the scene when Elsa reaches the mountain that she needs to reach is quite good, when she finds out all of that. There's some, like I said, visually it's very well done and the animation is spectacular, but ultimately the revelations that come have little to no impact for me because their narrative is a little bit muddled. Like I said, it's not a terrible film. I don't hate this movie. I like it, but I think it's fun, but I think it didn't tell its story quite as well as the first one. I understand it's trying to establish a new mythology and a new lore to the Frozen franchise. I guess we have to call it a franchise now. Whereas the first movie had a simpler story and it told it much better. So sometimes less is more, and I think on this occasion it was a little too overcomplicated, a little too much going on in terms of the story, too much exposition. I think, you know, so maybe the younger kids may not get it as much, or, well, unless they're true Frozen fans, which is likely. Ultimately, to me, it just doesn't have a lot of impact. It's a fun movie. I can see kids liking it, but I can't see it being as successful as the first one. So, yeah, there we go. But it was nice to see the continuation of it all. And as for the songs, I don't really remember them. I'll go through the list and sort of give you the names of the songs, but none of them were as good as any of the songs. Any of the songs from the first one. Into the Unknown, that's quite good. That was probably one of the best ones, actually. Some Things Never Change, All Is Found, When I Am Older, which is Olaf's song. I don't really care for that. Reindeers Are Better Than People. Yeah, weird. Lost in the Woods, Show Yourself, which is good. Idina Menzel performs that one. The Next Right Thing, Into the Unknown, which is probably the best one. Oh, that's a reprise, sorry. All Is Found and Lost in the Woods. So, yeah, there's a nice list of songs. They are good, and I think Into the Unknown is probably the best one. I'm quite surprised that this movie didn't actually include Let It Go, which is the most famous song in Frozen from the first movie. They didn't include any version of it in this one at all, which was quite surprising. But, oh well, there we go. So, yeah, Frozen 2, I would say it's decent overall. It'll do, you know, it's fine. It's perfectly adequate for what it is, but it's not anything special to me. It's, you know, the first movie is better than this, and even though this movie doesn't actually have a primary antagonist, it doesn't need to. It doesn't really need to. The situation itself is the sort of, I guess, the antagonist, really. And sort of the past, you know, what they learn about really is more a threat to them than another person would have been, really. So, I mean, even then, that's one of the biggest problems of the first movie is the villain. Hans is a terrible villain. But, yeah, I think this film benefits from not having a main antagonist, so to speak. So I will give Frozen 2 an overall rating of 7 out of 10. Yeah, 7 out of 10 from me for Frozen 2. So that's my review of Frozen 2. What do you think of it? Please put your comments down below. Let me know. Thank you very much for watching. As always, I'm Mr. Tarnus 11. See ya.